You got some nice moves, Angela. You know something? If you keep moving like that, I think you're gonna wake up the dead.
You got 3 calls this morning. None of them good.
Yeah, well, I don't want to know.
Oh, I think you do, Francis.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you do.
Okay, I do. Wait a minute. Is any of it bad news?
But, Deuce, he's not happy.
Good. Well, that makes 2 of us. Hey, Angela, look. New tie, huh? You like?
Oh, yeah. Gee, you look great. You got a Charlotte on your back for 15 grand and you're out buying ties?
Angela, a man in my position has to look good. Besides, I only paid $5 for it. Who else called?
Father Nero. He said the next time we pay for masses, he wants cash. You balanced 3 checks on him already this month, Francis. He says that you're not being fair to the church, and they go out of their way to make your funerals look good.
Oh, yeah, they look great, Angela. You know what the Minetti miss? Father Nero drank enough wine to pickle the whole neighborhood.
Well, he wants cash for today's funeral, period. End of story. You look about as good as one of your customers.
Oh, leave me alone, Angela. I'm not in the mood. 3 aces and that moron Skippy pulls a royal flush. A royal flush, can you believe that? I need money, Angela. I need a lot of money.
That's what you said to Badoots, and he lent you the money.
Yeah, at 3 points a week. 10 grand turns into 15. It's amazing. The mourners leave yet?
Yeah, all 3 of them. What are you gonna do about Father Nero? He wants cash today.
You know something, Angela? You think small. Please lend me some money. Please, I'll pay you back. Come on.
You have got some nerve, Francis. You haven't given me my pay in 3 weeks. I paid the garbage collector for you, for which you told me you'd pay me back the next week. And yesterday, I laid out $47 in embalming fluid, and you want me to give you some money. Get a life, Francis.
In the broom closet.
Thanks.
Look, Angela, I'll get on my feet soon.
Francis, the only way you are gonna get back on your feet is when you start to realize that success can't be found in a deck of cards. Not to mention a muddy track.
Where did you put the soap before?
Top drawer file cabinet.
Thanks.
I don't know, Francis. Look at you. You give money to beggars even when you don't have it. Your father told me you actually took out $20 out of the cash machine to give to that old drunk that hangs out at the diner.
He needed the money, Angela, so he could go visit his mother in a nursing home.
He's at least 80 years old, Francis. What mother?
Where the hell is the stapler?
Same drawer. Some partner is lucky he could find this place in the morning.
Done.
What's done?
Done what?
The shoemaker. He's all prepped. He must have ripped those old soles off with his teeth. Those 2 front ones, they look like they could have belonged to Robbie Rabbit. One shot with the old hammer, a little glue on the lips, a couple of staples. Done.
Oh, my God.
Why is he fingering your nose?
Super glue.
Oh, for Christ's sake, here. Try this.
What is it?
Nail polish remover.
I can't believe you smashed old Cosmo's teeth.
What did you want me to do? Carry the guy all the way over to the orthodontist office? I could just picture that. I want you to set my friend's teeth back a few inches because when I close the casket, his teeth come ripping through the top. He looks better now than when he was alive.
Suppose his family notices.
Well, It isn't like we can give him back his money. Right, Francis?
All right. Gordo, go get cleaned up. We're going to roll out Mr. Calabrese.
Roll out Mr. Calabrese and get cleaned up. All right.
And I hope the family brought the balance, Angela.
Oh, like I need this. Leone Funeral Home, it's our pleasure to serve you. Hold on. Francis, guess who? Can he call you back? He's with a client at the moment. Uh-huh. Will do.
Are you insane, Angela? I can't possibly imagine why you would do something like that.
Use this for the church fee. A married man would handle his business different. Oh, by the way, that was Badoots on the phone. He just wanted me to give you a preview of what's going to happen to you if you don't pay him by 6 o'clock.
The only way to be successful is to go and take what you want. But what Shakespeare said, once more onto the beach, dear friends, once more. And that's that.
Exactly.
So what do you guys do, eh? You sit around here all day long, you drink that rocket fuel, you play cards, cha-cha, and then you just go home to the wives and kids. Come on, do something for yourselves. Go out there and make some money. Now look at me, am I the best or what? You think you'll ever see me hanging around here waiting for a social security check? Not in your life. It's profit. You guys understand what I'm saying? Pure and simple profit. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. What's your money?
With all due respect, Badoots, you started out with a beefsteak. And what are we gonna lend out? Our piggy bank money?
Don't be a wise guy, Angelo. You know, Gordon, you shouldn't do things like that in a place like this.
Sorry, Vince. Let me have a...
Yeah, I know. Double, here. Just take a shower once in a while, Gordo.
Look at this mutt. Your lucky Caesar ain't that fast.
Yeah, you're lucky I'm not that... What do you mean by that?
All dressed up and nowhere to go.
Sit. You stink, Gordo. Beat it.
Hey, Badoots. Why don't you lend me $5 so I can take out your sister and turn her into a vacuum cleaner?
What? You know something, Gordo? You're going crazy from all that stuff you pumped into those stiffs. And you still stink like a skunk, you bum.
Hey, Badoots, when's the last time you put in a day's work?
Sit. This is not a man. This is a bum. Yeah. Your partner has a bad habit of forgetting his debts. Maybe he doesn't realize the seriousness of not returning my money.
No, he realizes. He just figures if he waits long enough, he'll probably get bumped off, and you won't be able to collect.
Oh, that's it. Sid. You got a sense of humor, Gordo. I like that. You got no sense, but you do have a sense of humor. By 6 o'clock tonight, I will have everything that's coming to me. Or I will have that rat's nest you'll call a funeral home.
Call sales. I'll see. The Dutz.
It's your sister. She's crying.
Well, what now? What's the mother?
Deal the cards, deal now.
John Michelina, what's the matter? That's not possible. Hey, 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 don't cry, don't cry. He's not worthy of your love. No, 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 you'll not take your life for no man. Calm down, Nicolina. Everything's gonna be all right, you'll see. Stop crying, you're gonna hyperventilate. Well, take one of your pills. Well, take two. Hey, take them all. Take it easy, Nicolina, relax. Look, I'm coming over to the house tonight, I'm gonna straighten everything out, yeah. I'll be over later. Till I get there, lock the door, relax, okay? All right, I'll see you later. Oh, Nicolina, stay away from the windows.
How long do I know you, Bedutz? Wait, don't answer that. I know you since before you were born.
My only sister. I send her to college, I give her money, I look out for her, and she breaks my heart. She marries this overgrown zit. He behaves like some teenager who's OD'd on Spanish Fly. But what do you mean, since before I was born?
Here, drink this. It'll relax you. Better, huh? Yep, since before you were born.
That'll get you.
By the way, how's your mother?
Ma? Well, thank God, she's okay. You know, always cooking and cleaning. Oh, what else does she have to do? I mean, she don't want for nothing. Hey, God don't make them like that no more.
Have another shot. Take some advice from me, Bedutz. Get that guy out of your sister's life. He's bad news. A nice girl like Nicolina wrapped up with a spitball like Richie.
You know, Vince, I like you. I feel comfortable around you. It's almost as though we were related. Before I was born,
that Francis, a nice fella. A little scatterbrained, but he's good inside. You know what I mean?
He owes me. He owes me big time.
Hey, nobody's perfect. He tries. He's got a lot of heart. Hey, look at me. A long time I was away. I was a stupid kid. I thought every truck that come down this block had my name on it.
You did time?
Three nickels and then some. What's the sense of talking about it?
My old man. He died in a joint. I never met him.
I ain't old.
What?
No, nothing.
Yeah, well, I can't complain. My stepfather took care of me.
With my money.
What?
Nothing.
Yeah, well, anyway, Vince, thanks for the drinks, eh? I gotta go. Hey, come on, you. We got business.
Well, I got a game.
Come on.
Am I a charity? No. Absolutely, positively, 100% no. Right. I loaned your money twice already. You never paid me back. And whenever you came into this bank, I gave you a calendar. Did you lose it? Hey. What do I speak, Swahili? Hey, I'm not gonna burn anywhere when I die. Oh, yeah? And we'll see, Monsignor. Same to you. All right. Goodbye. Well, well. If it isn't the king of the poker players.
Hello, Mr. Richards.
Hello, Francis. What can I do for you? Hey, no. Don't tell me. You need money. I mean, shoot me if I'm wrong.
Mr. Richards, the old neighborhood's not what it used to be. Some of these people don't want wakes. Some don't even want funerals. You know what that does to my business? My volume goes down. But I got a great idea. Great idea on how to increase business.
Go ahead, I'm all ears.
Okay, you ready? I advertise like crazy in all the newspapers. Maybe even on the radio. I get this. Plan a rest.
What?
Plan a rest.
Okay, I give up.
It's like a layaway plan. See, you put down a small down payment, figure you're gonna die in maybe the next 5 to 10 years, and when you go, bingo! Big elaborate funeral fit for a tycoon. And at a fraction of the real cost.
Sounds like a pyramid game. So how do you make money?
Well, see, if you don't die within the time frame of the agreement, you lose your deposit. Think about it. Most of our clients will probably be middle-aged, live to be 100. I'll clean up. What do you think?
You're a character, Francis. All right. What's the punchline?
I need $15,000 for the advertising.
$15,000?
Yeah. I mean, isn't that great? That's all I gotta do. Just get the ads going and, you know, sit back and collect nothing but money.
You're crazy, Francis.
No, brilliant.
No. Crazy. Now, please, leave.
What's the worst that could happen, Mr. Richards? This whole neighborhood suffers an outbreak of salmonella. Everybody dies and I go broke. But that isn't gonna happen. I would need the money today.
Get out. Get out. Get out! I'm a busy man! I don't need my time wasted with this nonsense! Get out of here right now! Send in the next fool. Bring me a laxative. Plan arrest.
Hey, Richie. Come here, you sick son of a bitch, you.
At least we'll go in the back or any business. Hey, my wonderful problem, how you doing?
Richie.
The dudes. Looking good, the dudes. That's a nice suit, isn't it, no?
Never mind my suit. What did you do to my sister?
I did nothing at all. She gets cold.
Cold? Come here, you little
Oh! You know, timid.
No, I don't know.
All right, well, let's just say her middle name should be, Missionary.
Why, you rabid dog, you. You mean to tell me you wanted my sister to act like some pickup off the street? I love my sister. You hear me, mister? You respect her. You respect her or I'll destroy you. I'll cremate you. There won't be enough left of you to feed my fish.
Calisthenics. That's what I'm talking about here, Badoots. You know, a little variety.
I'll give you a little variety. First I'll shoot you, and then I'll stab you.
Oh yeah, right. Oh yeah, big man. Big killer. Hey, but don't you know, I'm not some ironwork you can throw off the top of some skyscraper.
That was an accident. An unfortunate accident. What will happen to you will be on purpose. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Please, I'm bitches on my grandchildren. Please, I'll give you the money. I'll give
you
the money.
Take the money.
Take this, you son of a bitch!
Mrs. Kayafa, what are you doing here? It's all right, he's gone. Where'd you get
it? My Ralphie gave it to me, but he didn't give me any bullets.
Hey,
if my Ralphie was here now, this wouldn't be happening to me now.
It's all right, it's okay. I'm going to take you home, all right?
No, I don't want to go home. Ever since my Ralphie died, I can't stand to be there anymore. I just can't go on anymore.
You have to have courage. Come on.
I'm so good, just Francis. Taking care of the funeral and everything. No, we didn't have any money.
I was glad to do it. Forget about it. Come on.
Such a good boy, Francis. Your mother, she was such a beautiful woman. To die so young. The devil! That filthy, filthy devil!
Oh, what devil?
With his fancy suit and all his jewelry. He should choke on it. He should choke on it until he turns blue.
Mrs. Kayafa, you're going to get sick. What devil?
My Ralphie was the best iron worker in the city. The best. He could walk on a tightrope. A tightrope, Francis. Nobody could beat him.
Skyfall, look over here. Go, sit down.
The dudes, he should die. My Ralphie was going to pay him back, little by little. You know, a little bit at a time. But no, Mr. Badoots had to have it all, right away. Plus $900 interest. Oh, I miss him.
Give me a phone. Well, ladies, looks like by this time tomorrow, I'm gonna be in the funeral business. this way. Thanks.
Hello. Oh, answer it, service? Yeah, well, tell Mr. Leone that I want my office painted green when I take over tomorrow. Or money shade of green. But dudes. Yeah. What?
Speaking of angel, I guess I just walked in.
That's devil, pinhead.
Oh, he's cute.
Hey, shut up.
I'm hungry.
Canada, right?
Dudes. I'm tired. I don't have any money. I can't pay you. So you get my place.
So you've come to your senses, huh, Francis? That's good. Everybody, go have a drink at the bar.
Come on, girl, let's go.
But I'm hungry.
I told you to can it, right?
Francis, sit. Francis, Francis, Francis. Life's a funny thing, huh, Francis? I mean, we all work hard, we hustle. But what does it all mean? I got a sister that's married to a bum. I mean, all I want is the best for her. And she's married to a bad movie. How would you like to keep your business and have me forget your debt?
What would I have to do?
What? Marry his sister? And what do I look like, chopped liver? Oh, that's brilliant, Francis. Just freaking brilliant.
What do you expect me to do, Angela? I don't have his money.
You know, I have met some stupid people in my life, but you should have your picture in the dictionary next to the word moron.
Angela, I gotta marry his sister, or I gotta give him this place.
Maybe he'll get more than he's expecting.
Here he comes. Come on, let's go. Oh, but those...
I've spoken to my sister, Francis. She's very anxious to have you for dinner tonight. I'm looking forward to seeing my sister happy.
You know, I've been doing a lot of thinking about this, but dudes, and I'll tell you the truth, I'd like to meet her. As a matter of fact, you know, settling down is starting to sound like pretty good to me.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
Do it over there. Gordo, why don't you show our friends around?
With pleasure.
Angela.
Walk this way.
I never thought of one of these joints before. I think I could do without it, if you know what I mean. Well, who asked you?
Now this is where the real talent comes in.
Oh, I'm fading fast. You've got a couple of stiffs here. Hey, what's going on?
More than you'd expected.
Oh, what are you doing?
Getting ready to embalm.
With me in the room?
No, with you on the table.
Not with me. No, 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 no!
First we take out the blood, then we put in the jelly.
You're crazy.
And you're dead. First we cut the jugular, and then we cut the carotid. And there's the drainage. There's lots of drainage.
Gordo, stop fooling around. Let me out of here. I'll give you anything you want.
Don't trust him, Gordo.
What was that?
Murderer!
And then, I know you. Your son was a deadbeat.
My Ruffy was the love of my life and you killed him!
No, no, I didn't. He owed me. I can't be made to look like a fool.
Gordo, go ahead. He's a liar.
No, stop. I'm gonna throw up. I don't want to be dead. I don't want to be a bum.
Killed my Ruffy!
the tape recorder with your confession on it.
I'm sorry for everything, Nino. And to you too, Mrs. Caiafa. Your poor son really did fall by accident. My stupid son wanted everybody to think he killed him so he could be a feared man. He put the word on the street that if you owed him, you might die. Here, Nino.
It's not necessary, Vincent.
Yes, it is. Come on, Bedutz. I'm taking you home.
You all in this together? Get away from me. You're not my daddy.
I'll explain everything when we get home. Come on.
You know, I still can't get over what that Gordo did for us. What that Mrs. Caiafa. Oh, what a doll. You know, I wish I could have seen the look on Baduz's face when Gordo was holding the scalpel next to his.
So Baduz ripped up all the markers, right?
Yep.
And you don't owe him a dime, right?
No.
And no more outstanding debts, right?
That went red set.
Except for me.
Right. Angela, would you excuse me, man? I gotta do something. Excuse me. Hey, Butch. Hey, how you doing? It's me, Francis. Yeah, listen, Butch, you know what? I want to put $1,000 on tonight's game. On the under. I don't know. I got a lucky. Where you going? What are you doing? There's no way. Look, I'm proving to you.